I'm still awake, I'm good. True, my knowledge, I'm just selling love. Making plans like I'm ahead of you. But nothing ever happens if it ain't with you. If it for you, I never see America. All these places I go regular.
Hey guys, happy Friday. I'm back with another video. Please guys, do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Okay. So the topic today that I wanted to discuss, which I think is a very important topic, is my why. What is my why? Why did I start the Her Love Journey brand? Why do I do my YouTube videos? Y'all, thank God I'm healthy. I don't know why I'm still coughing like this, but I'm good, thank God. But yeah, I just wanted to talk about something that's really important, which is your why. Like, I feel like in life, you should always go back to your why, of why you're doing something, you know? So I kind of touched a little bit on this on my 2022 video. So I wanted to come back and just like elaborate some more. So what is my why? I kind of have two whys. My first why is because the reason why I do Her Love Journey, how the brand even came about, is because I wanted to make sure that I was motivating people to believe in themselves, and I wanted people to know that they are enough. They are more than enough. And where did this come from? Like, why do I want to all of a sudden let people know that they're amazing and they're more than enough? It came from me seeing the beauty in all those around me, the people around me, and them not seeing the beauty in themselves. In the past, I would be around a lot, like, not even in the past, like, even now, like, you know, you'll be around people and they'll do like a negative self-talk, you know, without even really noticing it. Sometimes we do that. Like, we'll talk negatively about ourselves and not realize that we're even doing it. So even in the now, you know, like, it's so important for me to let people know like how amazing they are, period. Like, every one of us, we're amazing, we're special. We have, you know, we could, as long as we work on ourselves daily, as long as we're working on ourselves daily, we could take over the world. All of us, we all have something special in us. So that was very important to me, to let people know that they're amazing. Let people know that they are more than enough. So that was my first why. It came from me being around people, even me with my acting. I don't talk about my acting a lot, but when I walk into a room or an atmosphere sometimes, like, you know, I will be looking at like a female or something and I'll be like, damn, she look good, she looks nice, oh my God, she's so beautiful, you know? And then like later on in the day or something, I'll end up having a conversation with this woman that I was admiring, and then they'll open up to me and they'll be like, oh, I felt so not ugly, like, I felt so insecure about this, about my outfit today, or something like that. And that always, like, till this day is a shock to me. Like, how I will see somebody and be like, oh my goodness, they look good. They doing it. And then they'll come to me and tell me how they're feeling, you know, insecure about whatever. So that's where the why came from, of where I wanted to motivate people and let people know they're amazing. So the second reason, this is the bam bam boom reason, like so basically in my life, I have an amazing life. I feel like I have an amazing life. I'm thankful for this life that I live. You know, I've been traveling the world since I was 6 years old. And my mom is just like me, and my mom's relationship is, we have a really good relationship. And my mom has sacrificed so much for me. The first tragedy, I would say, like tragic thing that has happened in my life, was me losing my dad at the age of 6, I believe. My father died. So that has been honestly the most tragic thing that has happened to me in my life. And basically, I was gonna say to make a long story short, but we're not gonna make this story short. So fast forward a little bit to college. Oh my God, this is hard for me to talk about. I didn't realize it would be hard for me to talk about it. So, y'all, I'm always crying, oh my God. So, in college, I went to Lincoln University. First HBCU, period. And I built, like, long-lasting friendships there. Like, my school is literally like a family. And so the second tragedy, like a big tragedy that happened in my life that, like, basically I would say, like, changed me, was me losing my friend Anthony in a car accident. And basically, after that happened to me, I became a little out of control, because it was just like a lot, like, you know. And like I said, like, for the most part, I have like an amazing life, and that was just like really, really hard for me. So I kind of went out of control. That was the first thing. And then when that happened, it's just like life almost kind of like lost meaning, if that makes sense. It's just like, it didn't make sense to me. So I started I don't think that's when I started questioning the meaning of life. Okay, so let's fast forward. Anthony happened. I feel like I went out of control after that. And then fast forward again. This is the tragedy that actually changed me. I ended up losing my second mom, Kalima. And that's when I totally started looking at life so different. But from those tragedies and me feeling the way I felt and feeling so low at the time, even in my low moment, I wanted to motivate people to know that they could survive through that kind of pain, if that makes sense. So that's where my second why came from. That was like such a crazy moment in my life for me. Those two moments, losing Anthony and Kalima. And I didn't want other people, like, now that I think about it, it doesn't make sense because we're going to go through things, like, you know. But I just wanted to spread joy and love and let people know that they could make it out of any type of situation. They could make it out on top of it. Like, you know, they don't have to let it overtake their lives, like, if that makes sense. Because I went through a very depressive stage during those moments. And even, it's crazy, but even me feeling like that was my motivation behind me not wanting others to feel like that. So, yeah, that's basically, that's my whys. Like, and now, that's the background of my whys. Today, I know my purpose is spreading joy. Spreading joy and spreading love, period. That's how we make this world a better place, by spreading love and spreading joy. So, excuse me. Yeah, guys, so I know that was a little heavy, but I just wanted to come and let you know why, where it came from, why I do what I do. And yeah, that's the reason. So I'm out here. Now I'm out here spreading love, spreading joy, and spreading light. Okay, and that doesn't mean to say, like, I don't go through things anymore. Like, oh, like, you know, yes, now I do go through things. I still go through tragedies. Life is happening. Like, you know, you're gonna go through things. But now I have a more joyful point of view of going through things, if that makes sense. You get what I'm saying? Like, life happens. Like, I have a more thankful perspective to life happening, basically. And that's what I want to share to the world, that we don't have to let these situations that happen in life, we don't have to let it take over our minds. We don't have to be filled with depression and anxiety because life is happening. You know, life is happening, so feel it, feel what you need to feel, and let it go and move forward and allow every situation to make you a better person, okay? That's how we need to deal with the life, this blessed life that we've been given. So, yeah, that is it, guys. And I'm currently in Connecticut doing some work that I had to get done, and I wanted to especially do this video behind the great Nipsey wall. I'm gonna show you guys. Actually, I'll show it to you after, okay? So after this clip. So, guys, thanks for tuning in. I really appreciate it. I just wanted to get my whys out there for you. And I will be continuing spreading that joy and spreading that love everywhere I go. That's on period. Okay? Okay? All right. Deuces. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment to the videos. Period. Okay? Okay. So,
I'm at the Royal Communications Center. I came here for a shoot. And so I wanted to show you guys the wall. Spoke some things into the universe and they appeared.
I better count my blessings. Life could have been more deadly, but it ain't real.